Today, we're looking at the Razer Wolverine V2 Chroma controller for Xbox and PC. And one of the first things I won't be reviewing is the button clicking sounds. You know why? Because why? They don't matter. Who cares about the sound the button clicking made? Okay. They mean something. But you know what? You can't hear them. You have headphones on. And that's my point. When you're playing a game, this is what it sounds like. See? No sounds. You don't hear no clicking. You hear music. You hear shooting. That's what you hear. Just stop putting in review videos. Okay, sorry. I'm feeling a little triggered. I'm under a lot of pressure. It's the holidays, and I'm not handling it well. Moving on. Almost every manufacturer in the pro-level controller market is releasing a high-end controller with additional buttons, interchangeable parts, and more, making this space increasingly crowded over the past few years. The updated Razer Wolverine V2 Chroma is a revamped version of the 2020 Wolverine controller that added 4 additional customizable triggers to the rear of the controller and 2 up by the bumpers on the front of the controller. They also added Razer's signature chroma lighting, which isn't going to help your gameplay whatsoever, but
you're sure going to look good losing while you're using it.
The real question you've got to ask yourself, is it really worth a buck 50? Oh, damn it. I just dated myself, didn't I? I was trying to be cool grandpa, get in with the lingo of the youngins, and I throw out a 80s word, right? It was an 80s word, wasn't it? I think it was. Who cares? A buck 50. Is it worth a buck 50? That's the only thing you've got to remember. The Razer Wolverine V2 Chroma is very comfortable ergonomically speaking, making it a joy to hold in your hands, tricking you into not noticing how deceptively light it is. Its overall form factor seems a lot like it was based off of the Xbox 360 controller, which was a great size for medium to large hands. The main grip areas, which are stylishly separated by an attractive Chroma RGB stripe, feels very well balanced in your hands, with a lot of weight seemingly centered where it needs to be centered, in the middle of the controller, making the grips feel extremely lightweight when compared to many of the other standard controllers out there in the market today. This controller is designed for Xbox Series X, S, and PC. You'll find everything is the same placement of the Xbox controller, except that the menu and view buttons are sit just a little bit diagonally across from where they would normally be at the top of the controller. And that feels good. I don't mind it. In fact, it's quite easy to get back and forth to those a little bit more than kind of reaching across to the middle of a standard Xbox controller. Speaking about buttons, let's get into what Razer calls mecha tactile action buttons. First off, let's just stop for a minute. Round of applause for the PR intern that came up with that phrase, although I'm pretty sure whatever pronoun she uses or he uses, probably ripped that off from a Transformers movie. Let's not go into denial here. That's what happened. And that's why creativity is dying in this world. We're all a bunch of copycatters. Meow. These buttons are designed to be faster and require less actuation or travel distance than standard controllers, similar to those found on previous Razer Wolverine Ultimate controllers. In fact, the Wolverine V2 Chroma gives a remarkable performance edge with 35% less distance to actuation and 40% faster response time. I'm not sure how they measured it, that's what they claim. Seems like to me it's another PR intern running on overtime. The controller feels great, it does, I'm not gonna lie about that. The buttons do feel like they have a nice pop to them and have a discernible click when pressed. If I were asked to explain the button feel, I would just describe the feeling by saying they have a bounce to them, as opposed to other controls that kind of have a spongy feel when you press them. This is quite noticeable when you're quickly pressing any of the buttons. I feel like this controller's buttons are way more accurate than a standard Xbox controller, as clicking in the center of the button or pressing on the outer edge responds exactly in the same time. A very important advantage when playing fast-paced FPS games that demand quick and precise input. You'll hardly find a situation where the input isn't processed due to not pressing the button exactly in the middle. The main selling point of the Razer Wolverine V2 Chroma is the extra remappable buttons. There are 4 additional triggers on the back side and 2 more up by where the bumpers are in the front of the controller, which can be customized to behave like any of the other buttons. The benefit here is that you can execute complex actions and combos without ever needing to switch your finger placements. By default, the triggers M5 and M6 act as sensitivity clutches for the two thumbsticks. Sensitivity clutch, in simple terms, is the ability to constrain or slow down the cursor up or down, left or right, to improve aiming. As an example of personal preference, I have jump on my right stick click, and sometimes, in tense situations, I feel like I'm hitting the jump button every so often as my grip gets tighter on the controller while reaching for the rear buttons. I've since remapped it, again another strong point of the controller configurations in this, to make M3 my sensitivity clutch for the right stick, making it easier to reach, and this works out really well for me. The two left and right buttons in the front I've left as default, and they appear to map to X and Y buttons on your 4-button area on the controller. Another feature of the Wolverine version 2 controller from Razer is the ability to lock down the paddle pulls. So if you want to have a faster FPS shooting actuation, you would lock the paddle that you use for shooting and probably leave the other one unlocked unless you actually needed that one locked as well. Unlock means full pull, lock means half pull. And it's a very unique design, I've not seen it on any other controllers. Okay, enough about the gumdrop buttons, Mr. Gingerbread Man. It's not about the gumdrop buttons. I don't care what anyone tells you. Let's move on to the all-important stick feel. I really enjoy the Wolverine V2's analog thumbsticks. They're very smooth to rotate, they freely glide around as well without any kind of hindered movement of any kind. And they return to the center position almost instantaneously when removing your thumb from it. When you click them, it feels like a lightning response, and you'll notice it in your gameplay when you compare it to the standard Xbox controller. Just like the Xbox Elite V2 controller, both thumbsticks have magnetic attachments for the cap, allowing you to change either one out for a taller concave cap, which allows for better accuracy when aiming in shooters, or a smooth convex cap that provides more smoother movement of your stick. One of the last design elements to talk about is the detachable USB-C cable, which is arguably the most controversial feature of the controller because it lacks a wireless option most players are used to. It returns us back to the days when we all sat around the original Xbox, and this will probably confuse younger viewers, much like telephone booths do when they come upon them. From a performance and reliability perspective, a wired connection is always preferred. So stop whining on your couch, potato population. The supplied cord is like 9 feet long, okay? That's plenty of room. I'm pretty sure it'll reach to your couch. If not, thanks way your living room. The Razer Wolverine Chroma is worth it. Sometimes, the old ways are really the best ways, so suck it up, Buttercup. One of the other main annoyances about the remapping software that Razer gives you is it appears to go full screen, and I can't figure out, or I haven't seen anywhere it says to put it in a windowed mode. And it's a little bit annoying, but again, I'm only going to use that to remap 6 buttons, and I'm not remapping too much of anything else that's on the controller. The other thing I need to mention is once you make your remapping selections, it is written to some kind of ROM inside the controller, so wherever you take the controller, those settings will carry over with you. The other benefit of the Razer controller setup for Xbox is that you can store multiple profiles in it for different games you might be playing at any one given time.
During the course of this video, you'll see on my sticks on the Razer controller the precision rings. The last controller I used was a controller I used to fly drones, and there's a lot more precision in those than there would be in a game controller. So I needed something to kind of stiffen them up, and that's what I chose. They're very helpful to manage dead space, and the material is kind of like a foamy, collapsible styrofoam. So they worked. I like them, but they're not good enough to make a whole video about, so I'll just put that here.
Razer's Wolverine V2 Chroma has replaced everything I have for a controller because I liked it that much. And after using it and seeing improved gameplay in your daily FPS wars, you'll probably agree. Yes, there are personal preference arguments to be made, but they are few and far between. For the most part, if your hands are medium to large and you can maneuver pretty nimbly, you won't want another controller. I am not a mouse and keyboard person. I just like how keyboard was sledgehammered into place as a game controller. For me, the keyboard shortcuts are all over the place. I'm a person that grew up on arcade games, Xboxes, PlayStations, and Nintendo's N64, pretty much before computer gaming and keyboard use came into focus. I can handle a mouse and keyboard, but why bother? If I can get a controller like the Razer V2 to fill the holes of the mouse and keyboard, then I'm well on my way to playing my style as I like it. Some people just have the mouse and keyboard DNA. Me, I just want to blow things up. Play a gunfighter, the way I always used to in the past. Mind a boom boom, throwing out all the reasons for you to convert from mouse and keyboard back to controller and live the good life once again. See ya!